let's go, let's go, let's go. In a world where one person creates a coaster parody, and then suddenly everyone runs out of ideas and has to do the same thing that person did, Six Flags decides to make their first ever RMC hybrid in Six Flags Over Texas. Wait, Six Flags Over Texas? The Six Flags Over Texas? Like, the one that's being treated really badly?
Yeah, Six Flags Over Texas. The one in Arlington, Texas.
Oh, so they finally care. We're finally going to get a coaster every 2 years now. Yes!
Six Flags, you monster! And don't think by adding alcohol and power wave, that makes up for this monstrosity of a decade. Ugh. Let me just continue with this parody. From the theme park chain that becomes best friends with RMC, only because they're cheap, comes the greatest coaster creation of that time. Yeah, I said it, that time. Because Iron Rattler completely demolishes this coaster. So take that over Texas.
Yeah, Iron Rattler! Wow!
New Texas Giant. Wait. New Texas Giant? Is that its real name? Like what? Did Six Flags think that by putting a new in front of Texas Giant, you automatically assume it's a new coaster? And that everyone's gonna call it that? It was made in 2012. That was really old. Come on, Six Flags. Why would putting a new in front of Texas Giant make everyone call it that? Watch this.
Hey, Thrill Buddy. What do you think of Over Texas' RMC?
Oh, you mean the Texas Giant? I love it.
Don't you mean New Texas Giant?
That's what I said.
No, you said Texas Giant. The real name is New Texas Giant.
Really? I didn't know the Texas Giant was its name.
You called it Texas Giant again.
Because that's the name.
See? Point made. The new in front of the Texas Giant is very unnecessary. It's almost invisible. People just call it the original name, Texas Giant. There's many ways to name this ride. Twisted Giant. Steel Giant. Iron Giant. Oh, I see, that's why. So in Over Texas we got Judge Judy the Coaster. A Texas flag that screams in the air. A mountain that can run away. And a Texas Giant that's not new. What are people in the future gonna think about us? Just imagine that.
Hey Grandpa, what's your favorite RMC?
Oh, New Texas Giant. I've always loved that.
Why do you call it that? It's not new anymore, it's really old.
No, it's not. It's classic.
Okay, Boomer, I'm gonna go ride Six Flags Over Texas new ride, new Shockwave, and after that I'll ride new Joy Scream.
Dang, those Gen Z enthusiasts in the future are so annoying.
Okay, Boomer.
Anyways, board the Cadillac-themed trains, because Ford is on the trap around T cars, and Ferrari has their own theme park, so Cadillac will do. And make it seem Texan by putting longhorns on it. Yeehaw! And pull out of the station in the actual forceful first turn, only in the back, and start ascending 153 feet. And as you get closer to the top, notice the sad little coyote stuck there ever since the ride opened. And ignore the sign because there's no time to discuss this. And drop down 148 feet. Which, once again, you'll feel if you're only in the back. Pull into an airtime hill, and then experience the most dangerous part of the ride. The wave turn where an accident happened. Drop again, and this time into another wave turn. But it's not important because an accident didn't happen on it. And you guessed it, another wave turn! But this time, that makes you think you're about to lose your head on it. Wow, Six Flags, it's like you want these accidents to happen. Next, go into the brake run, which isn't really much of a break, it's more like a 0.5 second break before diving off again. which, for once, Six Flags finally did something right, so, awesome. Take note, Trip Ride Rocket. After that 0.5 second break, go up through another airtime hill, and the most genius part of the ride, an airtime hill through the lift hill, which inspired many other coasters to do the same thing. Except, where's the inversion?
New Texas Giant doesn't have any inversions.
What? But then why does Fiesta Texas have it?
Because Fiesta Texas is better, and we deserve the inversion.
Be quiet, Iron Rattler fanboy. You don't understand how New Texas Giant didn't get an inversion and Iron Rattler does.
You are not okay.
You know what's not okay? The fact that RMC doesn't have the brains to put an inversion on New Texas Giant, their first RMC, and then they do with Iron Rattler as soon as it comes. That makes no sense.
You're just mad because Over Texas is your home park.
And you're just mad because you can't ride a big boy coaster like I can.
Oh! At least I completed my coaster credits for my height limit. Unlike you!
Oh! Fine, let's just continue this coaster parody.
Good.
Next, do some small little airtime hills that are extremely forceful in the back, and go into a tunnel that may or may not have lights or fog working inside. Then, once you go out, go into another tunnel that may or may not have lights or fog working inside. And the last tunnel that have nothing working inside on purpose because they ran out of money, and get those teeth ready for the picture time. And finish the coaster saying, "Wow, I survived the most dangerous and unsafe coaster ever."
You make this giant sound like a GP coaster.
Well, that's because it is.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a GP coaster.
Okay.
Not New Texas Giant. Ride it whenever this virus is completely over. Only at Six Flags Over Texas.